Well, there's the headline for today's blog entry. Mike Huckabee said that Billy Graham's death is fake news. He also said he's more alive right now than he's ever been. Check it out.
You know, Sandra, when I heard this morning that Billy Graham had died, I said, that's fake news. Billy Graham's not dead. He's more alive right now than he's ever been.
Okay. Fake news is one thing, but fake religion, or apostasy as the Word of God calls it, well, that's quite another thing. But for Huckabee to claim he is in heaven right now, well, I have scriptures to declare truth on this that cannot be denied, and so I have to ask if Huckabee believes or even studies his Christian Bible. And the reason I ask that is because I see him doing what all the apostate wolves have been doing for literally eons. I mean, to claim someone is in heaven at the moment of death is simply unbiblical. There isn't a single Bible verse to back that up. As some of you may already know, I have a page on the website that goes into great detail regarding what happens when you die. And I only made that page to show the Bible verses that these false preachers refuse to share because they easily expose them as false prophets. And if you want to see what I mean by false prophets, check out my Many False Prophets video when you get a chance. But according to the Bible, no one goes to heaven or hell at the moment of death. I mean, Jesus himself stated to Mary Magdalene after resurrecting that Sunday morning in John chapter 20, verse 17, he said, "Touch me not, for I have not yet ascended to my Father." But all these preachers keep declaring that he did the moment he died. I mean, they literally declared Jesus lied in their strange life after death theology, because that's the basic reality here. Jesus said he had not yet ascended, but yet they are saying in their doctrines today that he did, or everyone does for that matter. I also did a video on this some years ago to summarize this truth for those that preferred a quick answer. And so I'm not going to go into much detail now on this, as I see no need, since there is already an in-depth study as well as a video for those that need the truth on this. But I will share one Bible verse that speaks of a prophetic event that will happen when Jesus splits the eastern sky, that confirms all those preachers, pastors, or priests out there are lying when they say you go straight to heaven the moment you die. It's in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 16 and 17. It says, "For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord." So I have to ask, how is it possible for a preacher to declare people are in heaven right now when the Bible clearly says that the dead in Christ, Christians, are still in their graves and will rise first from those graves when Jesus splits the eastern sky? I mean, I thought they said they were already in heaven. I mean, do they go to heaven, you know, hang out there for a few centuries and then slam back into their graves right before Jesus returns so as to make the lying preachers on earth appear to be preaching the truth? No. Jesus Christ does not need to use deception to back up his word at all. He has the unadulterated truth on his side that is eternal and unchanging. I mean, the basic reality and prophesied reality here is the moment those Christians come out of their graves on that great and dreadful day, all those preachers declaring lies about the state of the dead as it is described in the written word of God will be forever exposed as the wolves Jesus said they were 2,000 years ago. And so why do they preach people go to heaven or hell at death? It is so the prophesied false doctrine of demons can be believed over and above the word of the living God. I mean, as we know, Satan does all he can to make Jesus Christ look like a liar, right? I mean, those demons need that false doctrine about the state of the dead so as to go about masquerading as dead loved ones preaching lies of hell by claiming they're actually messages from heaven so as to confuse the masses. And as we have seen for eons, these demons have appeared as dead people to make the common man believe the Bible lied about the state of the dead, and some of those demons have actually moved many church leaders to preach all sorts of their hellish doctrines by simply showing up acting like a dead saint. Now do you see why the elect cannot be deceived? The obedient bride of Christ is known to be one that studies their Bibles. And they know that their Bible says that they should believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of God, because many false prophets are going out into the world. Thank you for watching. God bless.